special slot for your fleshlight. Or should I say your bonatude?
On a hole.
Into right three.
On a hole. Oh, that's right.
But a hood. Yeah.
It would be like JoJo, except instead of saying aura aura, they go ona ona ona.
Oral, right. Oral, oral.
Oral hole? It's your oral hole?
Into left four, immediate turn square left.
I don't know, like, people are into different things. I'm not one to judge.
Oh, are you in Germany? This looks like Germany.
No, this is Wales. This is one of the more famous tracks that they've
created. I didn't know Wales had trees.
Oh, it's got a bunch of trees. But yeah, this track is called Sweet Lamb. It's
Sweet Lamb. Okay, I know Sweet Lamb.
Left six over crest. Right two long, don't cut.
Is it called Sweet Lamb because it's fucking brutal? And like,
it's called Sweet Lamb because the first part of it looks like the body of a sheep.
Right three long, 60.
Oh, that's adorable.
I think, like, that would be my guess because I've seen like the topography of it.
Right six.
That makes sense. I thought it was because you see Wales is known for sheep raising and like the first people to drive it like crashed and hit a sheep. And it's like named in memory of the sweet lamb that was killed. And then they ate it and it was sweet, so.
I'm glad that you went that direction with the Welsh and sheep.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, that was after they fucked it, of course.
Left four, two,
oh! Hilarious!
Let's enforce stereotypes.
And right six over
what's this about? Beepus.mp3? Here comes the Beepus.
Ty Tuesday found the text-to-speech program that was used in the Moon Colony game from NASA.
Ayo!
Yeah, exactly. And he made something while under a fever. He called "Here Comes the Beautiful Beepus." MP3. Then he put it on Vocaroo.
Into right three long, stay mid, long outside, and left six. Into right six, left six. 40, turn square left.
I also sent that link to Fritermus, and he's messing with it.
Continues 130, turn head.
In between bouts of watching AGDQ.
Into left six, 60.
Oh my god!
Caution turn left three.
This is amazing!
What?
Into right six.
Here comes the beautiful bee!
It's like a choir, except for Beepus.
Oh my god, I'm downloading this. Fuck.
Are you gonna make it your ringtone?
Yes!
Are you then gonna cancel and go to something else for your ringtone?
No, no, I'm downloading this.
Two times to one.
Okay.
My old ringtone was Goodbye Moon Man from Rick and Morty.
That is a good song, and I approve of it.
But it was getting old on me.
Yeah, so now you need a beautiful Beepus. Oh shit, shit, no, no, no. Okay.
Caution, left four logs crest.
I lost, like, at least 2 seconds from that flub.
Into right two times to one long, don't cut.
Because otherwise this this is where I usually gain
the
second.
Into left four times to 380.
And the last one.
Crest into left five. Over crest. Right one.
Oh shit. Shit. Piss. Fuck.
Into right three.
This car is kicking my ass and I'm not liking it.
Square left, don't cut. And right six, left six,
I
crest,
think my
right
graphics
junction,
card might be
six,
pooping itself.
Into left four pressed and turn
yes,
right
I approve.
Here comes here comes
yes.
You guys have to give you my phone into number right just so you can call me four, and it can go, here comes the beautiful beep, like in awkward times.
Into right two, into left five.
Holy shit, that is so good! That is so good!
80 pass junction, turn square right.
It's very good. You gotta say thanks to Ty Tuesday for that one.
Fuck, I am.
Into right five long,
good job.
And caution, left four long over crest, into turn hairpin right.
So,
left four continues for 100. Don't cut.
The world record for this track was done in this car.
Left 640, left 3.
And I figured, since the Audi was kicking my ass, and I wasn't liking that, I figured I might as well drive something that people like.
Left 6 into open hairpin right.
And this car is, it does its thing.
Left 6 over crest 80.
Oh shit.
Do you not like?
I like this car. It's, well, I like it better than Audi. Then again, every single car I've played in this game has been better than the Audi. Not even joking. That thing was keeping me on the exact same track for over a month. And I wasn't having fun with it.
Keep mid over crest, 80. Right 5 long, past junction, 100, past
big, biggest difference between the two is that this car
caution slowing 80 over crest
was made
water splash
for four-wheel drive.
Caution, keep mid over jump, 100 down, braking, turn a cue right.
When in fact the Audi, it was made to be
it's the rear right flat.
It was made to be a front
two
wheel drive.
One long, opens to two long.
But so they put the engine way in the front.
60, caution right 4 over big jump.
It is done.
And right 6
it
over
is
big
now
jump,
your ringtone.
Down, right 3 water splash. Right 2 through yep. Gate, opens past junction.
Great. I'm proud of you, Cecil-tron.
Left 5 opens crest into right 6 long 60.
So,
finish.
I think for the extent of this stream, I'm going to be retrying this track over and over again. Hey, look, I finished it ass first. +27 plus split time, that's good, right?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I got 27 seconds.
Into left 4, immediate turn after left. 60, keep
the
right
leader.
Over small pressed. Into left 2 times to 1.
Oh.
And I figure that's not too bad.
Into right 4 long. Into left 6.
Oh, I see.
Into right 2 long.
Like, that's an improvement
into
on my
four,
33
five,
seconds
two
before.
Into left 3 long, 60.
But are you going to be the world leader?
Left 6 over crest.
Right, oh, because that's Russians, cut. Right?
No, Finns.
Oh, cheaty Finns?
No. Finns are just good rally drivers in general.
You think it's because they are a barbarian country?
I think it's because they never really got around to fixing their roads. Every single road they make is fucking shit. So, instead of fixing their roads, they just said, hey, be good rally drivers. And so they became, like, proficient at rallying.
Oh, so they're like, yes, this is like the road outside of my hometown of Lili-Lili-Lili-Lili-Kloop. That's how Finns sound, right? That's how their language sounds.
This is how they sound like.
They sound like.
They sound like, yes.
But their language is like. Oh, I see.
Long,
I was misspelling K K K K K K K L L I I I.
Okay.
I mean, because have you seen written Finnish? It looks weird.
Yeah, I don't mind it.
Like
mostly
Welsh.
Because like it weirds you out because you're part Anglophone, and they have a lot of yeah.
There's nothing to do with Latin.
But. They have a tendency to use a lot of portmanteaus.
So they wear hat racks. I
yes.
see.
Yes, hat racks.
Continues 130, turn hairpin right.
Literal, like, hat and coat racks, just like in their houses.
Fuck, I lost 3 seconds here.
Oh, do you get punished for,
No. It's just... I had a good split time on the first two... split gates.
And are you gonna try and make it up?
Of course. That's what the rest of this track is for. But if you check the bar on the left...
Yeah.
So I started at the very bottom and I'm going up.
Oh, I see. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
That's a distance marker and then it goes white, green or red depending on if you were over or under.
Yeah, it judges the improvement I have in the split time. So, you see, I'm still behind now. But since I'm less behind than I was before, it's green.
So... Navigation. Let's talk navigation.
Yeah.
The number associated with it, is that the length of the turn or whatever? Or?
Basically...
Or the sharpness?
Okay, I'm gonna have to talk to you about Recce or Recce?
Yeah, no, I'm familiar with Recce, which is reconnaissance.
Yeah. But, during Recce, like, the very first round of Recce, there are essentially taped bars across the steering wheel, each which has a number. The further,
you have to turn...
Yes, the further you have to turn when going at about 30 miles per hour, or even slower than that. Just to make the turn, the lower the number gets, so...
I see.
Of course, it all depends on which team you're on, what car you're driving. Some teams have different systems, like there are a few that have numbers up to 13 or 14. For this system, 6 is the easiest turn.
Right 6, left 6.
Of course.
Oh, I see, actually.
Yeah. Of course, there's one more thing. The system, like, the numbering system, only assumes that you're on flat ground, ever. So, let's say I was on flat ground on tarmac, then this upcoming left 4, I could do that. In fourth gear. Assuming, of course, my gearbox is set up as standard.
Hmm.
Keep left over. But because
you have to drop gear to keep your tire spinning.
Not exactly. It's because I'm not on tarmac, I'm on off-road dirt.
You need more grip. You need more torque, right?
No.
No?
Look, on tarmac, I could take a right 4 in fourth gear going max speed of that ratio. But I'm not on tarmac, and it's not flat ground. So I have to assume that I would, like, if it was just one of those, then I might have to take it in the middle of fourth gear. Or, because it's downhill, I would have to drop down a gear. Just because that's the speed I would be taking the turn at.
I see.
This is very useful because, different cars have different grip, and the ratios of the gearbox are set up to accommodate that. That's of course assuming that, well, I'm using the standard setup. Oh look, I did sweet land, now it's time to do it in reverse!
Wait, really?
Yeah.
It says geufron forest.
Yeah, but look at the maps. And in Sweet Lamb, there's the arrows at the very right. And on...
I see it.
Yeah.
Four, three,
and
two,
one thing that's interesting
one,
is that usually
go.
You take...
Right four, 60 over bumps.
two stages per day, and that's reflected on the state of the car. So I'm already dirty from my trip through Sweetland, and that didn't get clean. Like, best case scenario, you get time to switch out bulbs on the lamps, on the lights, and that's it. Oh, and tires.
Left 4 through gate. Pressed 150,
see,
past junction.
You might have seen a white thing just above the XABY keys buttons.
Into right 6, stay mid over crest.
That's me
into
clutching
six,
off.
Ooh, you don't need to tell me about that.
No, the clutch is very important in this car because it has a very high-pressure turbo. So if my engine is liable to stall if it goes too low in first gear. So if I want to get it going again, I have to take the clutch off and rev up. So that it can, well, rev up without any resistance.
Into care, left 6, crest bump, right 2, long, ditch inside.
Also, it's a good idea to engage the clutch while in the air, because there could be a difference in the velocity of the tires, which are all connected to the engine otherwise, and just the velocity of the ground below you. And
so you literally like put your foot on the clutch as you're in the air to avoid screwing up all your engine.
Yeah, it gives you a bit more grip when you land, because when you land you get pretty much zero grip. Your car just it freaks out. Basically.
Yeah, that's how cars work.
Yeah,
they're not designed to fly into the air.
Yeah, but that's just one way to lessen the impact of that. And when you release the clutch, then you get the rest of the effects of this difference. So just the engine eventually matches the revs with the wheels. Fuck. I'm not good at this.
Into left 6. Into right 3. Into left 2, long opens 100. Care logs. Right 5, 80 through dip. Right 3 over crest. 60 keep left over crest.
So,
right 4, don't cut, 60.
I'm using semi-automatic transmission, which means, well, the computer decides which gear I'm in most of the time, but I can ignore the suggestion and go up a gear or down a gear, like a sequential gearbox. And because I'm in a semi-automatic and not a fully automatic, I can use the clutch, which is a really good idea on these on cars that are in Group B and higher.
Turn left 140.
I'm gonna have to redo the stage, but I want to do the rest of it right now so I can, well, just get some
into right 6, immediate turn hairpin left.
Some time with it.
Into left 4, long.
So, tell me, Ceciltron, how has your day been?
Oh, well, I'm going to go to the market, and I'm going to buy beer and fresh vegetables and fruit.
That reminds me, I really should go to the mall and maybe buy some cider. Maybe one of those sour beers.
Oh, sour ale!
Yeah,
you need to try it.
Yeah.
Also, your back window doesn't have a wiper.
Well, why would it? I'm not going to be looking at the back.
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right. You don't need to look behind you when you're rallying.
Yeah.
Unless it's a long-distance rally.
Well, these stages are 10 kilometers, and that's, like, very short for a rally stage. But the engine...
You know what we should do? We should do that rally where they go all across Russia and Siberia in the same car with like four people.
Yeah.
We should do that.
I would like to do that if I could afford it. Like,
yeah. Let's become rich people who can afford to do it.
I would like to do it in like a lot of sports Jeep. Like the ones they used to make in the 80s. You can get those here still.
But they're pieces of crap.
No. See, the thing about Russian cars and Russian Jeeps is that they're made for Russian roads.
Oh,
yeah. So they might break down a bit, but the reality... The reality is... Cecil-tron, please.
Sorry.
Let me finish.
Yeah.
The reality is that they are made for roads that are really, really bad. They have suspension that is both comfortable and made for off-roading. So, yeah, they might require some maintenance, but they do get across some really, really bad shit. I mean, you remember the demo for spin tires, right?
Yeah.
And you remember that Jeep that would get everywhere?
No, you need to play spin tires.
Okay, but...
So I can watch you spin the tires.
I do have spin tires. I've only ever played the demo, though.
Also, that's a nice overlay you got there.
Thank you! I made it myself.
It's looking fancy.
Well,
but your B is slightly off-center.
Is it?
Very slightly, like 1 micrometer to the left.
Okay. I'm gonna have to check that out, because by default, it shouldn't be doing anything.
B's a weird shape, though.
Yeah. Bad zone by Hell Orbs. I'm gonna...
It's a good song.
Oh, right. My rear window was clean before I did this.
Yeah. And then you went through the dirt.
Yeah.
The mud. And then you rolled over and...
I did a rally in the dirt.
How dare you? How dare you, sir?
I dare very well. I'm a daring do er.
I don't think we're now.
One of the best things about rally drivers and rally cars is that they drift a lot.
You're drifting the train! Two track drift!
I really want to read Densha the D. Because, well, it's silly. It's
yeah,
really
it sounds fucking retarded.
It's made by the same guy who made Initial D, but more to make fun of himself. Like, what if I made this really dramatic thing about a really dramatic... about a thing that lends itself to drama. And about a thing that doesn't really ever lend itself to drama. That's Densha the D, and I think it was just a single chapter one-off. I think they call those an omake, or a gaiden. I'm not sure.
Yo.
Yeah.
What you got?
What have I got? I've got mad skills, yo. I've got I've got the ability to take a car from A to B, no matter where those two are. I am the guy from Driver. Drive, I'm sorry. Have you seen Drive? It's a fucked up movie.
Press jump, baby. Into right 460. Yeah, I've seen Drive. Turn right six. It's a pretty good movie.
Yeah.
I like the part where the main character wears a giant head.
Wears a giant head?
Yeah.
Oh, right, the mask.
Yeah, I thought that was cool. Yeah. And then he commits, like, violence in a mask, and that was pretty cool.
Yeah. I like the influence Drive has had on cinema and music, especially. Though I don't really like
the influence it had on men's fashion.
Jackets.
Yeah, jackets, grandpa sweaters.
Oh man,
grandpa sweaters especially.
Grandpa sweaters.
Wait, you didn't like the soundtrack?
I did not.
It was like, I guess its influence was to make everything indie and twee, but also slightly 80s tasteful. I don't know, man. I really like retro, new, neo-retro-wave.
Synthwave.
Oh, synthwave. Yeah, I like that stuff.
I like synthwave, but I thought the soundtrack to Drive was not as good at being synthwave as the stuff that came after it.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Like, if you listen to the early stuff by Myrone, that's really good. If you listen to, what's he called? I can't remember what his name is. I think he's in. Like, if you listen to the soundtrack, like, to half the guys who got commissioned to do the soundtrack for Power Drive or Power Drift 2000. Like, every single one of those, I think, is better than the soundtrack to. Soundtrack to Drive. I'll tell you one thing, though. Drive made me want to watch Driver, which is. The movie that kind of. A movie that both inspired Drive and the video game series Driver.
Over crest jump, right five, and right five long into left.
Hey, you there?
Six long over crest.
Yeah.
Okay.
Into right six half long.
But yeah,
through gate, crest, and left.
If you watch
five long,
I really want to watch Driver.
Right 6 40.
It's a really cool movie, and you see a lot of the inspirations that Drive took from it. I've seen at least one chase scene from it, and it's amazing how much just the feel of that chase scene got made its way into Drive.
Oh.
Right 3 long cross junction.
Sorry, I spaced. What'd you say?
I've seen at least one chase scene from Driver. It's a movie from the late 70s, early 80s.
Yeah. I haven't seen that movie, but I'm aware that it was a film.
It was a big influence on a few things. One might say it's influential. But the thing is, it's so niche that not everything, like,
it's just niche.
Yeah, it's niche. Even though it's influential on a few people. A select group of people.
You know what I wish was influential? Was Le Samurai. A movie from the 1950s or 60s, I want to say. Black and white. One of the first film noir movies.
Le Samurai.
Le, like the singular, Le Samurai. It's about,
you know, I gotta
ask.
It's
about a private detective type guy.
You know,
that's pretty fucking good.
I gotta ask because I'm a dirty Islandi.
Islandi, yeah.
4, 3, 2, 1, go.
You're an Islam day. Islam and jam. I'm gonna transfer the laundry.
Okay, you do that. I'll just drive here in silence.
Left 4. Into left 6 over jump.
Shit. This. Fuck.
Into caution, left 3 continues over jump.
You know, at least one person who worked on this also worked on Sega Rally. You know, the new one from 2006, I want to say. Not everywhere. It's not anywhere anymore because it got. taking off steam. No, that's not a reason. The reason is because it has licensed cars. That's not a good thing when you become old. This game will eventually go off sale too because fuck you.
Into left 6, continues for 130 over bumps, ditch inside. Left 5, keep in. Into right 3 over crest.
Man.
Press right 6.
Into wait, they can just do that? They can take it off because the car's license expired?
Yeah.
That's fucking stupid!
You can go on Steam right now and look for the first dirt.
So I should basically buy a lot of copies of Dirt and wait until they increase in rarity and then some.
Yeah, you could make a lot of money that way, right? I think. But you'd have to wait a few
Steam
years.
Steam speculator.
Yeah, the first Dirt was also on Steam, but it's not anymore. I'm not sure about Dirt 2 and 3.
I should get a pizza.
Into left 5,
yeah.
Long ditch inside.
Like, I mean, it's pizza time, right?
Oh man, I love that poop.
Into right 6, past junction.
That's one of my favorite poops.
Into right 4, over crest,
oh,
right,
you mean, wait, you mean the one where the guy's dressed as the Ninja Turtles ejaculate on a pizza, right?
No.
And right 6,
I mean, Revenge of the Mad Madman by Deeper Cut.
Okay, I'll look that up.
I recommend it. It's one of my. It's one of the best poops in existence.
Okay, I'm watching it now.
Okay.
Right 6, into left 4, half long, keep in.
Wait, I got it. Yeah, it was.
Into left 2,
still...
keep in. Right 5,
still an hour before I got a Berg.
Right 1,
you might say
bump.
I'm a burgeoning
into left
person.
6. Into right 3. Into left 2, long opens 100. Care logs. Right 5, 80 through dip. Right 3 over crest. 60
go!
Left over crest. Right 4, don't cut 60.
You're liking
left
that 6, poop?
Long over crest. Into care, right four,
this is very strange.
Yeah, poops generally are.
Right 6 half long, 60 over crest, caution, keep left over crest, down, into right 4 long, into left 1 long.
Also, no, he's saying
into right
go,
six.
As in, I'm your boss, so get out.
Into left 6 over bumps, into right 4 continues over crest. Into left 6, 60
right
past junction.
4 continues over crest.
Turn left 1, 40.
Left 6.
Turn right 2,
left
don't cut
1.
Camber.
40 meters.
Into left 6.
Turn left 2,
into
don't
right
cut.
6, immediate turn hairpin left.
This is weird.
Yeah.
Into left 4, long.
Like I said. Poops generally are.
I heard Spider-Man, his eyes just start dancing, yeah.
Right 6, don't cut. Into left 6, 60. Left 3, long, don't cut. Into right 6, 60 over crest. Caution, right 5, into left 3, tight over crest.
It's also just a really cool showcase
right 6, crest, 130.
The good writing in Spider-Man
right
2.
Oh, Spider-Man 2 is a fun movie, and Alfred Molina is a fun actor.
Into caution, left 6, long.
Yeah,
like,
so is Richard Simmons.
Right 5,
Richard Simmons was in this?
Right 5, long, into
yeah.
Left 6, long,
no, he wasn't.
Crest.
Yeah.
Into right 6,
he
long,
was,
through gate,
the
crest,
newspaper guy.
And left 5, long.
He owned the daily whatever.
Oh, Richard Simmons. Sorry, I thought you meant Richard Simmons, the fucking dancing guy.
No.
The exercise guy.
Right 5 continues for 80 over crest. Tightens to 3.
What's his name?
Left 5 over crest continues.
Are they both named Richard Simmons?
I think. Hold on, look it up. I think it's spelled differently.
Richard Sims.
Sims. Okay. Yeah.
I think that was it.
Left 6 big jump. Right 4. Left 6 40 bump. right 3 long pass junction, into left 6 crest jump, right 5 long 60.
Showtime, ow!
Left 4 long, keep in.
The fun thing is that, it's just using that exact same owl by the guy in the bank, again.
Into left 3 long, into right 6 long, into right 3, left 6, right 4 pressed, left 4 long.
This is very silly.
Yeah. That's exactly what it is.
Into right 1 long, 60.
Though I do like the idea that the little tentacles talk like the turrets from Portal.
Yeah.
I
think that's funny.
Though it's also a child of its time, you know? It came out in 2008.
2010? Or, no, oh, you're probably right.
It got re-uploaded, is the thing. Oh, we got a guest. No idea who it is. Hey, guest. I still got the exact same difference in time. I gotta do this. Gotta do this right.
Four, three, two, one.
Sorry, what's that?
Right four long, six,
I got. I didn't improve.
Right you're still long, stuck on Sweet Lamb reverse. Yeah. You're still stuck reverse mounting the Sweet Lamb.
Left three through gate towards
like
splash.
A
left
four, real
into left six over jump.
Welsh.
Into caution, left three continues over jump.
Yes, like the
right
real Welsh.
Titans don't cut.
Fuck.
Shit. Into a cube
the difference is that I got the last time by
caution, keep mid over jump,
turning my car around.
Left four through gate.
Like a big dumb goof.
Press 150, pass junction. Left 6 over bump. 100 pass lay-by.
So, left right
four.
Around here. I was
right
8
six,
seconds behind.
Into right six, 130.
So this is already a 7 second
right.
improvement right here.
Into left 6, continues for 130. Over bumps, ditch inside.
Impro. That is not
I
how
think
a tire...
it's over, Joe.
Left
what?
Keep in. Into right 3,
yeah,
over crest.
I'm sorry. Also, that is not how a tire interacts with a barrel.
Press right 6, into turn left 3, tightens to 2, pass junction.
Yeah, I'm gonna do this again.
5, 4, 3,
what
two,
happened?
First 1, go. Right 4, long,
I,
how did you screw up so bad?
I
right
went
five,
too hot
crest,
into a turn.
Junction, left 3 through gate,
that's,
water splash.
That's... One of the
left
things you gotta
four.
Know about rally driving is that
it's
10%
caution,
going
three,
through the turn and 90% preparing to go
right
through
one,
the turn.
Titans, don't cut.
Is it because I'm talking?
Into a cube left,
oh.
Post inside.
My roommate says it's because I'm talking.
Well, your roommate is
jump,
a big dumb
splash,
baby.
Left four through gate.
He called a big dumb baby.
Crest 150, pass junction. Left 6
on what do you say?
He says he's not dumb.
Aww. Oh.
He said a dumb voice. That was the joke.
Crest into right 6, 130. Care crest into acute right.
Okay, so acute right.
Into left 6, continues for 130 over bumps, ditch inside.
There we go, that's much better.
Into right 3 over crest. Press right 6 into turn left 3.
That is not a handbrake usage I should have done. Okay.
Into right 6, 60. Press jump maybe past junction, 170. Care right 6 over jump, 60. Right 6 over crest past junction.
See, usually a good turn is done by throwing yourself into it and then just watching
press
the magic happen.
Right six,
a bad turn is
right
done by attempting to do that and
caution, right four,
having
long,
to pick up your own mistakes.
Three, turn, left.
Essentially, rally driving
right four,
is
long.
A lesson in not
into
fucking up
five,
the
long,
first time.
Caution,
because
turn,
that's faster.
Turn, square left. into right 6 past junction. Into right 4 over crest, tight. Keep
sorry, I was discussing ghost houses with my roommate. Right
5, keep okay, in. Tell left me about two. Ghost houses.
Well, ghosts basically have big stupid ghost faces and perfect butts.
Ghost butts.
It's the Film Cow series. You've seen it.
Well, tell me, if I were to meet a lady ghost, Bougie got a booty?
She would have, no, she would not have a booty, but she would have a booty, but she would have a perfect butt.
Would you say that she boo?
I'm gonna kill you. I'm just gonna fly to Reykjavik and stab you in the testicle.
The one testicle? You'd leave the other intact, then.
Into left 6.
Well, yeah.
Into right 3.
Of course. Into I'm not a monster.
Okay. Care logs, right 5. 80 through dip.
Why did I cut? I'm pretty sure my co-driver said don't cut.
Right 4, don't cut.
Here.
What?
I linked you the ghost house.
Okay. Right, you know that both of my hands are on a gamepad right now. 60.
No! I know.
Yes, they are. 60 over crest, portion, keep left over I have proved crest, my time right ever so long, slightly, but I'm long. Still 7 seconds behind, and that's terrible.
Into right 6. Into left 6, over bumps. Into right 4, continues over crest. Into left 6, 60 past junction. Turn left 1, 40.
Man, why does this game look so good?
Mostly it
into left 6.
I don't know, I think into part of it right is 6. That the encoding on this into is just the bare long. Minimum that hitbox demands
into caution, turn
so right, a lot of shit gets blurred out.
No, I mean the right game itself looks cut. Good.
Yeah,
I mean it's hitbox doesn't look too great.
You mean,
but no. Like graphically, it's pretty game.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Is just the encoding somehow makes your brain fill in the blanks.
Oh, I see. So it's not actually that nice.
I could send you a screenshot.
I mean, because I saw like gameplay videos on YouTube and stuff, and the game looked really pretty.
It can look very pretty, but it also takes a lot of resources.
Oh, I see. I thought you were building yourself a computer.
I was, and then I built it, and then my rebuild didn't include a new graphics card.
Oh.
Turns out this game is very graphics card heavy.
One of my roommates, is not here right now, he had a problem with his computer. He was turning it on, and it would just go.
Let me guess, he didn't connect his graphics card correctly.
No. You know what it was?
Right.
And this blew me away because it shouldn't have been that.
Yeah.
One of his RAM sticks was improperly inserted.
Oh, right.
But it's a common problem. But it's like, he was like, no, they're in right, and I was like, I push it, it's like, you get the little click, you know? But it's like, it doesn't make sense because it's not supposed to.
It's a common
RAM,
problem.
When RAM doesn't load right, it just dumps the stick. It doesn't load from the stick. But it was like, I don't know. I thought maybe it was like a clock issue or something.
Oh, also, every motherboard and every computer comes with instructions, including a list of beep codes.
Yes, I know. Except, who keeps those instructions?
I do. It saved me a bunch of times.
You're smart.
I know.
You are a smarter man than I, Joseph Dean. Gunga Dean. I need to upgrade this computer. It's been in its current state for about 6 months, but the motherboard is old.
But
my board's old and the network card doesn't work, which is weird.
But you don't have a job.
Sorry, the network card works. Yeah, I know, so I won't.
Yeah.
I mean the network card, the Ethernet port doesn't work. Yeah, that's right.
Please donate to Ceciltron's Patreon.
No. Yeah. No, donate to my Indiegogo. Buy beer. Waffles.
Anyway, on this run, I improved my run by 8 seconds.
Into caution, left 3 continues over jump.
So...
right 1 long, tightens, don't cut.
There's effective Saturday, December 12, 2015, Southwest Airlines will not transport hoverboards.
Caution, keep mid over jump, water splash.
That's good.
It's really good.
Crest 150, past junction. Left 6 over.
By the way, it's a good idea to brake just before a big crest. Because that means that the weight of your car is at the front.
Into right 6, 130.
When the crest comes.
Caution, crest into a cute ride. Into left 6 continues for 130.
Over bumps. Oh, the ghost test video, it always makes me giggle.
Left 5, okay. Keep in.
Into right. Next time you screw up your split time on the reverse sweet lamb, you need to check out this video.
Crest right 6.
Okay,
three
let's see. I can't see my standings right now. Because really, I just want to shoot for...
into right 6, 60.
Whatever advantage I got
crest
before.
Jump, maybe past junction, 170. Care right 6 over jump 60. Right 6 over crest past junction.
Then say that's good
care,
enough.
Left 6 crest bump. Crest right 6 left 6 right 6.
I'm in the green.
110 through dip. Caution right 4 long don't cut tightens to 3 over crest immediate turn left.
Oh, why did I cut?
Right 4 long.
I'm a fucking dumb face.
4, 3, 2, 1, go. Right 4 long, 60 over bump.
Cut is when you go into a cornered turn?
No, cutting is when you cut the corner.
Oh, you go
you literally cut the corner.
You just go over the dirt then.
Yeah. You go outside, no, you go inside the turn, like further inside than the track shows.
I see. Not a great idea if there's little flags and bumpy things.
It's a great idea if there's little flags. It's not a good idea if there's actual obstructions. Like a really, really gigantic... piece of shit.
Into right
oh,
stay mid over crest.
Like
into right
my brother.
Yeah.
If I
were to drive over your brother while he is inside the turn, then that
right
would be pretty bad.
Left six and right five
yeah,
over
it's pizza time.
Left three
pizza time.
Water splash.
There was a poster called Pizza Time, and everyone hated him because he was a shitty poster.
Oh yeah.
Why do all the bad posters have cool names?
Oh,
like
Pizza
Great
Time. Joe?
Yeah. Yeah, you're a terrible poster. I hate you.
4, 3, 2.
I don't know. Maybe somebody just calls him a shitty name and then they discover that it's in fact a good name. Because it's like an insult they turn into a real thing.
Shit, I just realized I have a bunch of rum.
You got a bunch
of cola.
You got a bunch of ramen?
Into a cute left post inside 60.
No, I don't have any ramen, I have rum.
Oh, rum and coke, okay.
Water splash, left 4 through gate.
I remember,
past junction.
There's a story about the Beatles bump. Coming here.
Past lay-by. Pressed left 4.
And,
4, 3,
she like loves
they,
you, yeah.
They, no, I
right?
think it, I think it was, no, the Beatles never came to Iceland, did they?
Let's find out.
I think it was one of those
did
big psych rock bands.
Did the Beatles go to Iceland?
Either way, big psych rock band, 60s, sent, like, a piece of paper with...
Here we go. The Beatles never came to Iceland as a group. Ringo Starr came in 1984 as a guest at the Atlavik Summer Festival in the East. He played drums, or maybe just the bongos. At least one song was Studmen. Mostly, though, you just hear I'm going to talk. Paul McCartney came in 2002 as a tourist and stayed at a hotel Valhall in Thingvellir. Valhall.
Yeah, thereabouts.
You gotta teach me Icelandic so I can fucking move to Iceland and start my new life as a goat farmer.
Why would you farm goats in Iceland?
Because goats are awesome and you guys need some goats. You don't have enough goats.
You're gonna sell your own artisanal goat cheese?
Yeah, the raw milk cheeses. Banned by the EU. I'm gonna be a goat cheese pirate.
It's a good thing you chose this this time to move to Iceland, though, because we, like, early this year, we sent, like, a letter to the EU saying, "Hey, fuck are you! We're not going to be a part of you." And they went, "Okay."
Wait, you broke out of the EU?
Yeah.
That's awesome!
We were never officially a part of the EU, but we were in the entry process.
I like the part where Iceland said fuck you to the banks and just kind of like redefined its own economy.
Yeah. That was a good idea.
It was! They can't invade and take it back. It's Iceland.
Well, basically the banks own every single senate in the world. Thereabouts. Which is how they came up with this too big to fail rhetoric.
Yep. Yep.
Like, that's the only reason any senate in any country would ever, like, agree to those terms.
Well, our politicians are bought and sold.
But because Iceland has such a small economy, and because we basically elected a new government immediately after the fall of the economy, and that government was mostly left, we didn't suffer the blow of most of bank corruption.
Hmm. So what is Iceland's main economy driver again?
Fish and tourism. Huh. Not in that order, though.
I'm cool with that. That's cool. That's cool.
Well, mostly,
fish is good.
We don't process fish enough, and we don't do enough with our fish.
Oh, you just fish it, and the trawlers are based in Iceland.
We fish it, we land it, we skin it and gut it, and then put it into packaging. There's not a lot of processed fish products that you can sell, really. So, even though...
You can make sardines. Mmm, sardines, I love sardines.
We sell cod, mackerel, and
probably herring.
Yeah, herring.
Into right six, immediate turn hairpin. This is don't cut.
Into left 4 long. Thank you for the reminder.
Into caution. I'm just trying to help.
Hey. Right six, I improved. I did better on this particular section than the...
Yeah, no, you're doing good.
Well, except
because
for
because you're
fact.
Talking politics.
Caution, right 5, into left 3, tight over crest.
Right 6, crest, 130. I want to go to Iceland. Iceland sounds so nice. Into
care, left 6, we got, really, we got a whole lot of motorsports going on, and it's finally on TV again.
Really?
Yeah.
Was it off TV for a while? Was there like a thing?
Yeah, it was basically there was this TV program called Motorsports.
Of course it was called, you know, Motorsports.
Motorsports. And they would cover pretty much everything from Formula off-roading to RC racing. Literally, there would be a small special on RC. It's kind of weird. But the thing is, it got taken off the national station, and sold to the one private station in Iceland. This happened in around 1999.
Oh. What'd you do?
Nothing good.
How did you do? How? How did you?
But the thing is, after it got sold, not everybody in the country could talk about whatever was going on in motorsports, so...
Was it because not everyone had this private channel?
Yeah. So, it pretty much fell out of popularity, and people didn't talk much about motorsports anymore.
Caution, keep mid over jump, water splash.
It was exclusive, and therefore, like, since it dropped out of popularity, the program got dropped. At the very latest, it got dropped in 2004, but probably much earlier. And we still had a motorsports scene, and there were still, like, hardcore hangers-on for Icelandic motorsports. But it wasn't on TV until last summer. Like, I showed you that, coverage in English of... Do our rallies and formula off-roading, and that was basically them rehearsing their editing skills for making a full program last summer.
And now Iceland's motorsports has been restored to its proper throne of motorsporting.
Yeah, it's been restored to television, which is a good thing. And right or long.
So you guys really like your motorsports?
I like
Is it because, like, Iceland is basically just, like, a lot of small villages, and then there were roads to join them, and then people like driving?
I'm not sure. I think it's mostly just cars are cool.
Oh. But, I mean, how does a country get that bug? You know, get the motorbikes bug?
Press jump, maybe. Like, there are a lot of different scenes in Icelandic motorsports. One of them is the Quarter Mile Club, which has been active since the 60s, I think.
Yeah. Drag racing!
Yeah, drag racing. It's not my thing, but the Quarter Mile Club has been doing non-drag race things while it's been acting. Right one, don't cut. Also, to celebrate their recent 60-year birthday. Oh wait, they started in the. That means they started in. Wait, the 1955. No, yeah, 1955. Right?
Yeah, sounds right. I don't know.
Yeah, to celebrate, they brought in. Like, the European jet quarter mile champion, like a jet car, and he did the quarter mile in 5.something seconds.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah, it's really, really cool.
Into left six, over bumps. Into right four, continues over crest.
There's also something I didn't know. Until just recently, because I got to watch this motorsports program. They put it on YouTube just recently. The whole, I think it's 7-episode season?
Immediate turn happened left.
Folk racing. There's a folk racing scene. That's really great.
It's a caution turn square right. Don't cut logs on exit.
Folk racing.
Yeah, basically the cars are cheaper than most cars. I think by my last count it was about 11,000 Canadian.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
So that's like €5, basically. Our dollar is worth nothing right now. It's so awful.
Okay.
That's the one thing is, it makes it difficult for me to travel because the Canadian dollar is worth nothing.
But,
I do mean it. It's really bad.
But,
Rachel, let's play a video game. Let's play a different video game. I'll order a pizza, and we'll play a game.
Okay, but you gotta suggest a game before you order.
I want to suggest Rocket League.
I'm up for Rocket League.
You have Rocket League, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Let's play it. Let's do it.
I wanna see if I make this run or not. And then I'll just click the game and maybe Berg.
Berging! I'm berging hard. I should get a Berg. Fuck, I'm hungry.
The thing is, my parents, they left some Bergs.
Parent Bergs! Even better!
Yeah, they got a Berg maker.
A
Berg press.
But you don't need a press to make Bergs. You press them by hand. You cup them in your hands. Do Icelanders have tiny hands?
No, see...
Can you not make burgers?
It takes less time.
No, it doesn't.
I fucked this run up, so... Sturzo...